Good morning, Moreland. Happy Thursday, December 9th, 2021. It is a day 5 in the day cycle calendar. It's Thursday. We made it to Thursday already. Can you believe that this week is nearly over? Tomorrow is our concert. Saturday is the pancake breakfast. Before I forget, I want to let everybody know that the pancake breakfast is free. I have not said that at any time. So there is no cost to the pancake breakfast. All I want you to do is come with your families. We want you to eat. We want you to visit the stations. And we just want you to have a great morning with your family. So it is free on Saturday. So there's some really fun things that are coming up to end this week. But we got to get through today. And it's going to be an awesome, awesome Thursday. So welcome to school, December 9th. There are no birthdays to celebrate today. Today's breakfast is the strawberry cream cheese bagel. Tomorrow's breakfast is the chef's choice. So whatever available in the kitchen, that's what will be for breakfast. Today's lunch is the mac and cheese for the main. And the alternate is, again, the cheeseburger. So the main lunch is the mac and cheese. And the alternate is the cheeseburger. Our core value color this month is yellow. Yellow is a color of sunshine, hope, and happiness, but can have different associations. On one hand, yellow stands for freshness, happiness, positivity, and energy. But a dull yellow can stand for caution. Bright yellow is an attention-getting color, and when used in combination with black, it creates one of the easiest color combinations to read and to see from long distances. Take a look around you today to see the color of yellow in your school and community. How might the color yellow provide a service to people while driving or walking? That's a great question. How can yellow provide a service to all of us in our community? Why would we use yellow? Why would construction workers or community members or teachers use the color yellow when they are choosing of all the colors to use? Why yellow? How does it provide a service? It's a great question to think about today. We are talking about service this month and providing a service and helping each other out. Yellow can be quite helpful in setting and giving some reminders to others. So great question to start today. Look for those color yellows and look for ways to serve others. Remember, our word of the week is altruistic. Altruistic means unselfish. When you are helping somebody else out, you are being altruistic. You're being kind and giving. Providing a service, you are being altruistic or showing altruism. Altruism is what we would like to see around the halls of Moreland, at your home and in our community. So continue to look for ways to be altruistic, but also try to use that word in your conversations. Speaking of using your words in conversations, our next chapter in our book is Use Your Voice. Once you have your once you've been practicing and have goals and have your team, it's time to use your voice. I know I've brought it up a few times, but I'm really proud of where I came from. My town doesn't have the best reputation, but let me tell you right now, some of the best people I know came from Wythenshawe. It might not be the wealthiest area or be in the news too much, but there's a lot of talent in Wythenshawe. There are good artists, great street footballers, and really great teachers. There are people living there who used to help me when I was a kid who are still there now, helping the next generation, lending a helping hand, providing a service. And there are children all over Wythenshawe, just like me, with big dreams and loads of potential, just looking for the right path to walk down. I learned so many things while growing up in Wythenshawe. You already know how I worked on my football skills there, but I also learned how to be street smart and the importance of keeping your head on a swivel. Wythenshawe taught me that why it's important to be polite to everybody in the country, in the community, from the people who run the shops to the teachers to the bin men, everyone who contributes to the place you live. I'm really connected to where I came from, and growing up in Wythenshawe, I learned how to be curious and ask questions. I learned to question why things were the way they were and to ask if they could be better. It taught me that when someone says, you can't do that, I could ask, why not? This wasn't just so I could learn to be confident in myself, but also because I genuinely wanted to see if it was possible to make a difference. So this is my message to you now. When someone says you can't do something, ask yourself, why not? And go from there. The support I had as a child helped me to realize that I could chase my dreams with my whole heart, and I want all of you to feel empowered in the same way I did. You can achieve anything, and I really mean that. I'm gonna stop right there because I think that's a really great way to start. believe in yourself. That's what he's saying. He's saying when somebody told him that he couldn't do anything or he couldn't reach his dreams, he said, why not? It's a great way to begin to empower yourself, to feel good about yourself, to challenge yourself to aspire to greatness. Have that individual tenacious spirit. So challenge yourself to be your best. Set those expectations high and then work and persevere to reach those expectations. And always, always, always be pushing yourself to go to the next level. More and more and more. Use that voice. Start to use that voice and your team will be able to help you. Your companions can help you use your voice. Have a great Thursday for those of you who are rehearsing for the concert tomorrow. Good luck today. Ms. V's here, I'm sure Mr. Funkhauser, Mr. K, I'm sure they're all gonna be here preparing for tomorrow's concert. If you have music today, good luck. I'm really looking forward to tomorrow. Have an awesome, awesome Thursday and be your best scholarly selves. Work hard and be kind. Let's stand and say our Moreland mantra together. I am kind, I am capable, I am valued. We are one. Remain standing for the national anthem, followed by the pledge of the flag, and you have a thoughtful Thursday. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Have a great day, Moreland.